For this question, you have to calculate the all-in price amount for bond A when it trades on the 10th of May 2009. Now, I've indicated the coupon payment dates here, 30th of November and 31st of May. And we said in the previous question that there are four things that you have to do when you calculate the all-in price of a bond. You have to first decide whether it trades cum interest or ex interest. You have to calculate the accrued interest. You have to calculate the clean price. And then you have to calculate the all-in price. So we're going to do the first thing now. We're going to decide whether this bond will trade cum interest or ex interest on the 10th of May 2009. Right. Now, when it trades on the 10th of May 2009, the next coupon payment date will be the 31st of May 2009. The previous coupon payment date will therefore be the 30th of November 2008. The register closing date preceding the next coupon payment date will be 1 month before that, so it will be 30 April 2009. Therefore, the transaction date falls in this period, small period, after the register closing date, but before the next coupon payment date. So, who owned this bond on the register closing date? It's only going to trade after the register closing date. So, on the register closing date, it still belonged to the seller. And therefore, who will receive the full coupon on the next coupon payment date? It will be received by the seller, because the seller's name will be in the register when the coupon is paid on the 31st of May 2009. But this is not quite fair, because from the 10th of May until the 31st of May, for that short period, it belonged to the buyer. That is a period, it is indicated there, of 21 days. So, from the transaction date, 10 May 2009, until the next coupon payment date, 21 days later, the 31st of May 2009, it belonged to the buyer, and therefore the buyer has to be compensated for interest for 21 days. And how will we compensate the buyer? The buyer will be compensated by subtracting the interest accruing to the buyer from the clean price. So when you are going to calculate the all-in price, it's going to be the clean price minus accrued interest. Therefore, this bond trades ex interest on 10 May 2009. So we've done number one, the bond trades ex interest on 10 May 2009. We've already done number one. We've decided that this bond is going to trade ex interest on 10 May 2009. So the second thing we have to do is we have to calculate the accrued interest. Now the accrued interest has to be calculated for this period, this 21 days that it belonged to the buyer. Now the formula to calculate the accrued interest amount is this one. Accrued interest amount is equal to the principal times the coupon rate per annum times D, the number of days, which is 21 days divided by 365. So I'm going to rewrite the formula. The accrued interest amount is equal to the principal times the coupon rate times D divided by 365. Now the principal for this bond A is 25.